What's up, everyone? It's your boy Scott. Welcome to the Scott Report, and today we're here to talk about Promised Neverland Chapter 131. And you know, this shirt would have been a lot better for my Bungo Stray Dogs video, but anyway, that's here or there. Cliffhangers galore in Promised Neverland this week. You know how they do it, because they're so good at doing it and how they actually do it, because we got a lot in this chapter and we got a lot of things that was unresolved. It's just making me more excited for next week. I mean, we got the Door of Night and Day, or whatever they called it. You know, Rey and Emma are on the path of finding the Seven Walls again. You know, that's a goal while Norman's doing his own thing. But the breadcrumbs that they had to follow all this time, you know, going back to when they met the dragon and everything leading up to the Seven Walls, because I missed last week and I kind of glanced through it so I could be up to date, it felt like they really didn't show how they got some of these things. But anyway, they finally got to where they needed to go. They got to the door, they opened the door, and then you see a shining light with Emma looking in awe, and it just cut away to the demons. But it was good demon content nonetheless, because we were introduced to the five regents, and we see that there's another Lord Baon, because you know, the one that we knew is dead. So there's that. But you know, it's a royal family. And as far as Baon, and again, this is just me with my hazy memory of this right now, I know that Baon and Lewis, I know these guys were pretty high, but I don't think they mentioned that they were one of the five regents. I mean, I felt like they couldn't have, because we just learned about the five regents in this arc. So anyway, yeah, this is the son of Baon, and things have been pretty underground with royalty. I mean, in this chapter, we got royalty bickering as they always do, you know, going at each other's throats, taking pot shots, things like that. It is revealed to everybody within the room that, you know, Baon is dead, or Lewis is dead, or should I say missing, because they didn't really say what happened to him. They said they were missing. You know, we get another, I think it's the son of Lewis too, but we got the son of Lewis, we got the son of Baon, and they're saying, you know, Baon, Lewis, Nos, and Noma are missing, because, you know, that wouldn't be good press for someone as high a caliber as they are to find out they got work by some kids. I mean, that just wouldn't be good at all, right? However, the biggest part of the chapter is that we got to see the Demon Queen. She looks pretty cool, I must admit. But you have to wonder, is she the head honcho? Is there a king out there too? You know, is she the end all, the be all? Is she going to be the final boss? Is she going to be just straight up merciless and evil? Does she have a good side? There's a lot of questions that I have about this, and I can't wait to get to this meeting and find out what they're talking about, because it cut away once we got to the good stuff here as well. And very Cersei Lannister vibes with the queen, and just in time for Game of Thrones, which is gonna start its final season tonight. I got that kind of feel from her too, you know, with the regents and her being the queen and everybody, you know, having to bow to her presence when she came along. But this is gonna be fun. This is gonna be interesting to see where they go with this, because she apparently is gonna play a big part in this role. And if she is as badass as like Lewis, and she's like a queen, that would be cool. I feel like maybe she's not the fighting type. We would just have to see. But it was good to see that, you know, wherever there is, you know, demons and royalty, there's always a queen. So I wonder if it's a king too. Is she the demon, you know, whose name is scribbled out? I don't think she is. I think that's where Emma and Rey are going, like when they're going through the Seven Walls. I think they're going to meet that person then. So if they are looking for the demon with the scribbled out name, then where is the queen coming to all this? This is very interesting. And because this is what royals do, a lot of things have been under wraps. Like, you know, Baon's son didn't even know Baon's dead. And when somebody was about to actually tell him, they was like, no, don't say anything. And the same thing goes for Lewis and Nos and Noma. Like, nobody knows. Well, people know, but it's like the whole world doesn't know, or the demon world don't know what's going on. So I got a feeling that this meeting that they're having is going to now solidify humans as public enemy number one. It got me a little bit worried about some things, because if this gets out on a mass scale, like even further than it already is, because the kids are already on the run. But if now they have some type of declaration, what is that going to mean for the farm kids? You know, if Phil back in the farm where he is this going to increase security? Or are they just going to straight up have a manhunt for humans? What are they going to do to them? It's definitely going to put them in danger if this meeting is about, you know, having some type of manhunt or having some type of mass destruction go out for the kids after what happened with Goldie Pond. Because I guess they feel that they can't keep this under wraps for too long. It's probably already gotten out and it's getting too big for them to handle. The next thing that I'm worried about is seeing that these guys are nobles, you know they're going to have an army. So this leads me into a little bit of worry with Norman as well. I mean, we know Norman, he's our boy, he has a plan, but some things that got me worried, and we know this is why he went and recruited the demons so he can have a little bit more manpower, but has he run into anything like Lewis before in his crusade and taking down these camps? I don't think he has, and that's what got me a little bit worried. And I just scared myself a little bit now, because this will be a very humbling defeat if Norman runs into an army that he can't take. He might not even come out of this alive. I don't want that. I'm reinvesting in this character again. I never lost, you know, investment in Norman, but now he's back and he's so badass. I don't want to see him get tripped up and get the upper hand in this battle, or lose the upper hand rather. And it looks like he might be in danger once again, because something else that I noticed about the demons too is that, and this isn't a shock because we saw this like with Musica, but these demons, the royals, are more humanoid in appearance. So I'm waiting to get more information on how that is. I mean, clearly it had to do with them consuming and how much they consume and what they consume. But it's something fishy going on somewhere, because this queen, you know, Lewis, Musica, they look like almost like they're a human demon hybrid. So we still need some answers. I mean, it was kind of revealed and we still don't know if what Norman knows is a complete lie. But I think the true origin of the demons is going to come sometime soon, especially now with the roles being, you know, introduced. So guys, that was it for the chapter this week. Let me know some of your thoughts. Again, I am deeply worried for Norman now, because I think we're going to get an army that we've ever seen. Like, I just don't know if Norman's run into anything like Lewis. It doesn't seem like that's in his game plan. So that's going to be a problem if there's more people out there like him. A little bit coy with getting to the wall with Norman and Ray. I'm sorry, with Ray and Emma. And Promised Neverland never ceasing to amaze us once again. This is a fantastic series. I mean, I'm pretty sure I can think of one besides Full Metal Alchemist, but I can't really think of a series that consistently knocks it out the park the way this one has. And this is why I'm so glad that I finally got back on the ball and started to cover this again, especially for the last leg of the series, no matter how long that would be. So, as always, if you like the video, go ahead and drop it a like. And if you want to hear more, go ahead and hit that subscribe button. As there's not a shortage of content for you to indulge on this channel. As I always say, you guys can be anywhere on YouTube right now, but you chose to listen to me. I really appreciate that, so thanks for stopping by. On that note, it's your boy Scott signing out. See you soon.